God, grandma TV don't never work. I hate coming over here.
There have always been two worlds. The humans and the enchanted. Since the dawn of time, humans have always been a self-destructive creature. The enchanted, however, were always gentle beings. Full of majestic power, the Jinn could not use their power for harm on themselves or others, so they never understood how these creatures were always suffering. The humans would pray and pray for help, and for centuries the Jinns kept to themselves. Over time, the natural empathy of the Jinn made these two worlds collide. Their struggle, their hardships, all washed away with magic. Not all humans were taught, just a small select few who could help others. This group was known as the Yuri gods. That's what the first group saw themselves as, mainly because the other humans saw them as such, began to learn about magic and the Jinns. They learned about what the Jinns could do and could not do. Jinns cannot kill themselves or other Jinns. Jinns' magic can only help or enhance, not injure. Jinns' magic works in a delicate balance within their bodies. Those rules became true of the Yuri as well. The Enchanted were pleased with the Yuri and left them to their own devices. But it wasn't enough. Unlike the Jinn, humans have always ruled by greed. And the Yuri wanted to be the source of magic, not just have it tethered. Unable to drain them and become pure magic themselves, the Yuri began binding the Jinns to human objects. Since they couldn't kill the Jinns with their magic, they locked them away where they'll never be a threat. Knowing that their magic couldn't cause hurt or harm, the few remaining Jinns cast a memory blanket on the Yuri and humans. If they couldn't save their people, at least they could make the humans forget about them. Through the years, the spell lost its grip. Different cultures made things up based upon what they remembered and told stories to pass it down. What is clear and true was the existence of the magic thimbles. These were the objects the Jinns were bonded to. The thimbles were discovered by ordinary humans. The years of imprisonment twisted the nature of the Jinns. Spiteful of their fates and vengeful of their circumstances, they too started experimenting behind the scenes. Over the centuries, the servant and the master roles played out. And then a strange thing happened. Ordinary humans started to fall in love with the Jinns. Some Jinns were wished free and became mortal, married the humans, and even created children. These were the very first wizards. Genetically carrying magic without any of the restrictions of the Jinns or Yuris. So, with the help of the wizards, the Jinns were able to overthrow and conquer the Yuri. Sadly, lessons learned were forgotten, and the wizards became lustful for power themselves. They too experimented on humans, stretching their own limits. The very first attempt to fight back took Europe by storm. The Black Death, they called it. Children were the worst. After it was fought back and everyone affected were killed, there was peace, and we thought it was over. Until now.
Ha ha ha! I put a spell on you. Because you're mine. Because you're mine.
Oh, What news?
This is still the same. The world is covered in darkness with no light in sight.
It's so few of us now.
I mean, we can make them forget it again. It lasted the stars like before.
Mateo.
These powered humans are just like the Yuri. They'll see that it only lasts a night long and no longer.
What can we do?
We can fight them.
How? A rebellious one, you plan on doing that?
Go on then.
I mean, we can always do that.
Why must we be bound to decency and good? Wouldn't it be right for us to just take out the power of humans?
We are the sources of light to heal this world with love. Our gift is to heal, enlighten, blossom. It is intrinsically part of our makeup, our magic, our essence. It makes us who we are.
So why can't we fight them? We've never tried before. You say that's not who we are, but that's hardly an explanation.
Quentin, you were the last of us to be created, so you weren't around during the time of war.
Warwick?
My brother. He felt the same way you did. Humans were destructive, chaotic, soon to destroy themselves. He saw them as a plague on this world. He felt that without them, we could have a more prosperous world with life from the animals and life from the skies.
See, Mateo here had a different view.
You did?
Yes, I saw what my brother was talking about, the hurt and pain inflicted by them. I saw them as lost. Water without a bed. Running everywhere they could, spreading themselves far and thin. But if given guidance, patience, a little help, I saw them achieving great things. Far beyond what we could see.
And now? Do you still feel that way? Warwick was right.
Quentin, Warwick saw us giving help to the humans, you know, teaching them. And he wanted to stop us and try to twist in his inner light to achieve this.
Our bodies are made woven with magic. Once turned, it attacks itself like leprosy and cancer to humans. Our bodies don't know the difference between bad magic and good. Warwick inflicted a bandwidth of evil upon the humans. But it didn't turn out like he thought it would.
Instead of Warwick's magic killing the humans, it gave them pride, envy, gluttony, lust, sloth, and
greed.
The overwhelming want for our magic. Our imprisonment. The non-stop hunt for us?
My brother is responsible for the horror we are in now. And maybe I should have listened to his concerns. Took more time.
No, he unleashed war upon the humans. It destroyed his very essence. The whole time we were helping them, his magic lay within dormant.
And you continue to help them out of guilt?
Bryce? I mean, we're not proud, but...
But?
Look, we have to remain true to our core.
Mateo, you're the eldest of us. Our leader. Our kind is all but washed away. Drained and enslaved. So you tell me I sit in the dark corners of the world as a sacrifice for your penance?
It isn't the humans doing? Many of them weren't around during the time of magic. It's these power humans with any conflict left.
Wizards.
What?
That's what people call them. I've been around. People aren't under this memory charm. People who know follow them and take it for themselves.
I know.
So why don't we just absorb the magic back? You say it's a part of us, so why can't we just consume it back?
I also said that they don't know the difference between good and bad magic. You see, if you were to shoot magic at me, my body would simply absorb it, since at your very core, you're good. But these wizards, as you call them, they're not like us. They're a mixed blend between us and humans. And in that human part lies Warwick's imbued magic, his darkness.
I won't sit idly by while this continues to happen. I will stop the wizards with or without your help.
You can almost be forgiven.
What's that?
Cheerful ignorance,
the glee,
the innocence of children who play here. They have truly no understanding of what's happening around them.
Well, maybe it's better that way.
Yes, maybe it's better.
So, while I sense this hesitation from you, Maurice,
why go after the Jinn? Why in this way?
Sweet Maurice. The Jinn are not who they pretend to be. They bend the will of men at their whim. And when they're bored with us, they simply toss us away.
We have what we need. We have magic.
Magic is like a refrigerator magnet. We can only affect ourselves, pull and push minimal things, and only under certain circumstances. As time goes on, we grow less and less powerful. It'll eventually disappear forever.
Well, that's still more than anyone else. And at least we have each other.
If only it were that simple.
But what if it could be? Let go of your rage, Oliver. Let it go. I have. They literally can't hurt us.
No, they can't.
And soon, it will be gone.
Not that soon.
This is serious, Maurice. I wouldn't do this if it weren't.
All these years you haven't been able to cope.
How can I, Maurice?
It's not their fault what happened to your mom.
No? Not their fault?
The people stormed our house, Maurice, looking for him. My mother hid me just in time before they came in and trashed the place. Everything that I knew. I can hear her. After all these years, I can't remember her face. Oh, but I can remember her voice. And she pleaded with them. Please stop. He's not here. Over and over. They wanted to find him, drain him, to soothe their curses. They blamed him and the others for their fate.
Who could blame him?
Where is he? Where is he? Then they walked away.
They searched for him. I had the smallest drop of hope when I heard them leave. My mother, she was crying, but they were leaving.
And then I heard one of them ask, where is he? And I knew they meant me. They must have seen one of the drawings I made on the table. And my mother, she wasn't the best liar at all. When she told them he wasn't there, it was the truth. But when they asked for me, she panicked. They killed her. And I saw it all.
We both weren't strong enough then.
No, we weren't. But we are now. And those people are still here, infected. Now the one last thing I love is here and defenseless.
Oh, I'm not defenseless.
No, I guess not. But if we don't do this, you will be. We both will.
But nobody remembers that or even knows about it now.
They always do. They'll always come. That's a part of Warwick's curse. The glaring point is that they will always come. And we'll just be...
just like everyone else? And no one will care or come for us?
Until they do. Because they always come. We could live our lives centuries at a time. Safe and sound. But they will always come, experimenting on us, trying to drain us, to see if they can find that one moment to spark, if just for a moment.
But we would have lived, Oliver.
Yes, lifetimes. But I can't let that happen to you.
You're not the only one that's had loss, Oliver. The very same people came for my father. When they couldn't find yours, they took mine. They tethered him to a dragon statue and drained him for decades until there was nothing left. I hate these people as much as you hate the Jinn.
And?
And I don't want to do to your father or to anyone else what was done to mine. It's time to stop this wave that Warwick set out. Let's have calm waters.
Even stopped waves have ripples. I don't hate them all, just my father. And as long as he's out there and the others are infecting regular people to make them monsters, I will not stop. I will kill every Jinn I find.
Thank you.
I just need a 16th. That should do it. Please let me go. I'm not going to hurt you. I couldn't even if I wanted to.
You don't have to do this.
I need you. This will never work with you so panicked. Let's start again.
And what is your name, human?
Maxwell. My name is Max Stone.
And Maxwell, what can I do to make you feel better about this situation? You can tell me why you're here. Why you're doing this? I need something inside of you.
Inside of me? What do I have?
All humans of today have it, Maxwell. Thanks to Warwick. All except the wizards. I just need a little from you to finish the solution. But the problem is it's latched onto your DNA. So how to do it? Either way that I'm thinking will cause you harm or might even make the curse worse.
You can find somebody else. I'm sure there's somebody better that could help you.
Perhaps, Maxwell, perhaps. But you were much easier to get with a simple favor. But it seems like your mind is worried about something.
I may or may not be having a baby soon. We've been trying and we've had some problems and I hope it's a girl. I'm just worried.
How do you feel now, Maxwell?
I feel better than ever. How did you do that?
I've been studying the tethering that Yuri used on us to pull and bind magic to a specific place. This should be what we need. To snuff out the light within the wizards and restore the balance.
Do I need that?
I told you I wasn't here to harm you, Maxwell. You're free to go. But that child of birth you were thinking of won't end well. But any new seeds that you plant will find root.
So I can have a child?
I'm always here to help.
How do I find you? Thank you. Let you know.
Oh, Maxwell. You won't even remember my name or my face.
City is hard to reach with normal means.
It's not like your powers are slipping. I'm sure you could have just teleported.
And risk your neighbor seeing.
Please, you're seeing what you want to be seeing.
True as that is, Oliver's got a net around this place, and I didn't want to ring any bells.
It's not gonna happen.
I was afraid of that.
Don't be afraid. Have a solution. Oliver and the rest of them are coming for the Jinn. You're their leader, Mateo. Have a plan.
Well, I did see something in the stars in the sky.
I don't need riddles, Mateo. Get to the point.
You did ask for answers. It's the only one I have.
Go on.
There will be an alignment of two worlds that will feel the effects of neither for being able to control them both.
An alignment?
An alignment. It's a person, okay? I couldn't see a face nor a name, but when the Jinn come together, one of them will have this potential.
That alignment you're talking about is the wizards. It's us.
Well, not from what I saw, at least not yet.
As careful as you were, Mateo, I still have people watching my love's place.
You have people watching my house?
Maurice. Not now, my love. Excuse me, Mateo. It did sound like a thrilling tale. You saw the savior in the stars and wanted peace. So you sent my father to Lyle with a human and have me.
Oliver, I did not know things would turn out the way they did.
Oh, but you did. The night my mother was killed, you called my father away on an errand so that your brother's greed curse wouldn't kill one of your own. My mother, she was merely a casualty that you could afford, but not him.
Oliver, I don't know what to say.
I dare say you loved him. Yes, love. His family was killed and torn apart. But he was safe with you. Never mind his son not knowing his father, or knowing who he was, or why after decades and decades he couldn't age or die with the people around him.
We did not know things would turn out the way they did.
We? Is it we now?
We didn't know how to enter your life without her coming. It's not our way.
Your way is merely to serve your own. Maurice was the first that I found that was like me. Different. Touched by magic from my parents. He showed me how to truly live and not be a girl. And then I met Kendrick and Noah. They were like us as well. But they showed me the truth that I had long forgotten. As long as there is a Mateo in the world, I can never truly be happy with this.
Oliver, consider what this means. Do you really want to kill me? Like Noah and Kendrick killed their parents?
Oh no, kill? Mateo, trust me, they will come after you also. Now, we may keep you around, tether you like the Yuri did in the old days. You'll be our own personal battery. First and the last of the Jinn. Now, you'll be the cure for Warwick's curse. And at some point, maybe we'll be able to create peace, tranquility, give people their sanity back.
You don't know what you're talking about. It's not just Warwick. Humans have struggled before our influence. We will not change anything. Doing this may result in something darker. Something none of us can stop.
Enough! Fairy tales of a savior, warnings of an apocalypse. Your words are empty, Mateo. As they always are.
Oh God.
Take away the war with affliction. What?
What are you talking about?
This will get rid of the curse that Warwick left.
Is that even possible?
Even better. This will absorb the magic from the powered humans. It will take away their cruelty, their desire to hunt for us. All that.
Quentin, I don't know what to say. Like, how? After all this time?
It's not important now. We can cure them all, take away their affliction, heal the mind, body, and soul.
No, damn it, it is important. Explain.
I cured a human from his Warwick affliction.
And you just, like, without killing him? Without hurting him?
I plucked it right out of him. Of course, the curse has taken root inside of the humans. It's weaved its way inside of their DNA. But this human, this stone, he was different. It didn't bond with his DNA like others. He had love at his heart, at his core. It guarded him. It was the perfect shell.
And you just plucked it out of him.
Transformed it. I plucked it out of him. I bonded it with Yuri tears. And I made this solution. I was only able to make these.
And he wanted to use his own wizards.
Powered he means, but humans nonetheless.
Without knowing what it would do to him?
This will work.
Will it work?
This time, we will stay out of human affairs.
But we can't hurt them.
It's for the greater good.
The greater good? You don't know if this will kill them or cure them. You don't know if it will eliminate the curse or make it worse.
This will work.
Will it? What if it makes more wizards? What if it gives more people magic? Did you think about that?
That's impossible. This has absorbent properties. It will get inside of them like a leech and drain the magic from them. And it will restore the light with us.
We have to protect them. I have to protect him.
This all happened because of you. Oliver is going to destroy us all. This is the only option that we have. We have no other choice. This is all we have. This is what we can do. Let's go. I feel like time is not on our side. Don't worry, Bruce. We can leave this one here to undo it and take this one. Okay? Wizards. You mean they can give me powers?
Took you long enough.
What is it? What could you possibly want from us now?
Steady, Quentin. Where is his name?
Oliver took Mateo.
What?
This is my fault.
No, it's mine.
I'm sure it is. But
No time to place blame. We need to stop this and fix it.
I need to find my son and end this feud. I know what that means. Follow me.
So nice of you to meet us here, Father. Well, I suppose you'd do anything for your man.
Please, Oliver, don't do this.
Oliver, baby, please. We still have a chance. Let's just go.
We are far past that now.
You leave me no choice.
End this here and now.
It's a shame. We owe you so much, but we can't let you stand in that way.
Well, well.
So horny.
What? You'll pay for that. The fuck?
We're
human.
This is your fault.
Can it be done now? My baby boy.
Y'all won't try to use that stuff again, will you?
What are they?
Quentin!
No. We won't unleash whatever this is on people. They've suffered enough.
We'll get rid of the other vials as well. Let us go.
And never return!
But Maurice...
If you come back, I'll kill you myself!
like there's some missing.
What?
Maybe I thought I made more.
This is it. This is done. This stuff makes people have reach like teeth and lust. Stuff we're supposed to get rid of.
Yes, well, this will die here now.
There's a new virus, a vampire virus. It's been spreading throughout everywhere in our community. We're not sure how it spread or how to stop it. We've learned that this man, Maxwell Stone, is patient zero in this crazy epidemic. Authorities have detained Mr. Stone and started his experiment in order to find a cure. But Mr. Stone, he passed away in the night, and he leaves behind a wife and an unborn child.